Hey guys, and welcome to Captain Charlemagne's Models. I'm your Captain Charlemagne, so let's head over to the bench and see what we're doing for today's project.
Hey guys, and welcome back to the next part of our building of the USS Montana / Ohio. So, in the last episode, what we did was we pretty much started installing a bunch of our smaller caliber guns. Well, our AA guns. So what all was done off screen? Well, not much. Just a few small pieces were added on that weren't there when we made the video last time. So we added on this piece here that onto the back rangefinder, and we added on these tiny pieces here that go onto the upper gun tub. So today we shall start off. We are going to add on the rest of our guns. Then we shall be adding on our rear funnel. So let's get into it. And well, I'm sorry if I sound tired. It's just been one of those weeks where it seems like it's just one of those. Very long weeks where it seems like the week just okay. There we go. Yeah, just one of those weeks where as you go it just seemed long. So but we made it through, and we are progressing. Not sure if that's how everybody else felt about the week, but that's definitely how my week went. Alrighty then. So something I've been thinking about over the course of this week is what we are going to do once we finish Montana. Well, once Montana is finished, we of course So, what I've been thinking for us to do for the build following Montana is we are going to divert from our traditional warships, and we are going to be doing the NX-01 refit from AMT, the one in 1000 kit. Now, This is something I'm aware that not a whole lot of people were gonna like, simply because, well, not a whole lot of people are fans of Star Trek. But I really like it, and I've been wanting to do one of the starships on the channel. And, well, this channel wasn't always directly going to be about warships. While I might like warship building, I also like building other models as well. And one of those models that I hope to add on to the channel is the NX-01 Enterprise. In fact, we have already done a starship on the channel while it was an unboxing, and that was the Enterprise C. So, one can't say there was not ever going to be such a chance, because such a thing had actually already been proven towards the channel. Another thing also is that we have almost, on my end, finished doing the sailors that are going to go on to USS Texas. They have all finally been painted. Yeah, and believe me when I say this, that took a while. I am so glad I had my magnifiers, because if I did not, I would not have painted those things. Just getting all our other 20mm ready. There's my straight pliers. Where are my okay, there they are. Tweezers, not pliers. Okay. Pardon me for a moment, guys. It's just I'm looking and this one is further back than it should have been. And with the fact I use super glue, it's kind of to fight me to come off. Okay, that's better. Okay. So, something interesting I've been asked recently. Over on one of the model groups I'm part of, I recently was asked by somebody, and this actually caught me by interest when they asked me it. They asked me, not interest, but surprise, was they asked me if I did commissions. And, if anyone here who subscribed to the channel is also part of those Facebook groups, I would like to make it clear that no, I do not do commissions. The reason being is not that I wouldn't like to, it's that the problem with being a commission, doing commissions, and I follow several channels where the people do such things, channels such as Canadian Starships, I believe Trekworks does it, and also, I forget the other gentleman's name, but all of them do it. The thing is that you have to be extremely careful with commissions. You have to do them exactly the way the person wants them to be done. So, for example, the gentleman asked me if I could do a, USS Guam. I think it was the 1 in 350 variant, and because his father had served on it during the war, and he had all that information and all this other stuff on it, which, to all those who serve, thank you, and to all those who have served, thank you. The issue with that is, while I was honored he would even ask me such a thing, it's that puts a large amount of, just turning this around. The issue is that puts a large amount of pressure in the fact of then you're having to do it to the point of practically museum quality. When you're building some of those models, you're having to be extremely careful while doing it. You can't make any real mess ups. Then you also got the aspect of, okay, so you're doing this, but you have to worry also about, once it is done, you're having to worry about things like, okay, how am I getting this over to them? Are they local? If they're local, they would probably be able to pick it up, but you're not always operating under such things. I believe the guy over at Canadian Starships, he's building a I forget the scale, Enterprise D, and I think one of those is going overseas, and, well, that's definitely something you have to seriously worry about. Because you never know how that trip's gonna go. You're also usually paying for the major shipping that's going on for those. And no offense to anybody who likes doing that stuff, but and building because it gives them joy, so they like doing stuff for other people. But that's
a big risk, no matter how you look at it, in my opinion.
Okay, we have done all the guns. All of those are on. All our 20 millimeters, all our 40 millimeters, and all our 3-inch have been placed. Now, we are going to be working on our rear funnel. So, you're going to need all our rear funnel pieces. I just realized we do not, in fact, have all of our locations where all our 20 millimeters are going to go. So, give me a second to. We are still building our funnel, but I gotta get the spots for where that's gonna go because those two pieces, I just realized. Where those last six guns are gonna go right here. I was wondering why it was still blank. But anyway, enough of that. Let's get all our stuff for our funnel. First part of our funnel is in our hands. Okay. Just making sure the two pieces fit together. Carefully run it across the edges on both sides. And then we are going to reattach these pieces together. Like so. Next, we're going to need is this piece here, F27. Okay. This becomes a game of playing with it. Or does it become a game only if I put it on the wrong way? Okay, that piece is on. We're going to need our Tamiya extra thin real quick. And because it's a smaller piece, we don't have to worry about adding any kind of major amount of glue. Sorry. Okay. Still need our tube glue. What I'm going to do real quick is just briefly pause our construction on that. Real quick, one of our things here. Oop. On this side. And we will add the other one as soon as we finish the funnel. Surprised I forgot about those. Alright. So, next piece we are going to need for our battleship is our funnel cap. Get our thing real quick because there is a little bit of stuff here at the bottom that we have to scratch away. Good thing that ain't a super tiny piece, or else the carpet monster would have struck again on me with this battleship. There we go. Our funnel cap is now on. Next, we are going to need E12 and E11. Okay. We shall start off with E12. Thank you. There we go. Next, E11. For a moment. Okay. I had to get closer to actually be able to see the freaking piece because it didn't want to cooperate to go in. Pick it up and it decided it wanted to come out. You know what? Hold on one moment. I'm ending the farce of this little piece. The funnel, she's all but done. The funnel just now needs to dry. What we are going to do, move that out of the way real quick, is we're going to add on the other side. Little gun hub. I still can't believe I forgot about this. Turn it a little more so I can actually see where I'm putting this. Got this piece a little I had it a little too far over. Do now is we got another thing that we can add on to our funnel. Aside from the little rafts, and what that is H64, so it's a photo etch piece. For this part, I'm going to need my magnifiers. Technically, I should also be wearing my glasses while doing this, but I need to clean them, so I'm currently doing this with a pair of magnifiers and blurry vision. To bend. Okay, and that right here is just what I was having to work on. So, you're going to add some glue to it. And we are going to attach it right here at the end of our funnel. That attached, we can attach on the funnel. Trying to put the funnel on backwards. Okay. I think I was trying to put it on backwards. Yeah, I was trying to put it on backwards. I just need to be able to see what I'm doing real quick right here. Okay. There we go. And with that, another funnel has been added to the battleship. And also with that, we have come to the end of today's episode. So, I would like to thank you all for joining me today. I hope you all have a nice day. I hope you have a nice week. Take care of yourselves. If you like what you see on the channel and want to keep up to date with any videos, then please do hit that subscribe button to be notified of any future updates. And this is Captain Charlemagne, and I'm signing off. Ta-ta, everyone.